Are you confused about what you need to teach in your maths units? Do you need an overview that tells you everything you need? Well, in this video, I'll be talking you through the maths small step planning resources for Key Stage 2 that you can download from the Twinkl website. Hi, I'm Holly from Twinkl, and this small step planning document, also known as an S-Plan, outlines the national curriculum objectives for maths and breaks it down simply for you and your learners. These S-plans are a great way to get an overview of everything you need to teach in one unit in maths. And there are plenty of suggestions for supporting resources and lessons. Let's take a look at the Year 3 Maths Number and Place Value Small Step Planning document as an example. Included in the document is a breakdown of the progression of skills linked to the objectives, together with possible errors and misconceptions that may arise. You'll notice an S-shaped path and a variety of coloured boxes. We have blue boxes. This is the learning intention. Pink boxes. This is the skills progression. A blue list linked to the learning intention and the specific skill. This blue list has clickable links to planning resources such as the PlanIt lesson packs. There are also clickable green boxes. These are the potential misconceptions with links to same-day intervention planning resources. And finally, the blue dashed box at the start and finish, which links you to the baseline assessment and end of strand assessment on this particular maths topic. So although these resources are printable, if you download them as a PDF, they come with the links to link you back to the Twinkl website where you can download even more resources to support your learners. Each planning document begins with prior knowledge. This is what children should already know from the previous learning the year before. You could even download the baseline assessment suggested here as a quick way to gain an impression of your children's current attainment in this particular maths area. Following the path along the S-Plan, you'll see that the blue, pink and green boxes, the learning intention, the skill required to progress and the potential misconceptions connect well to support your teaching. For example, let's say you are teaching to compare and order numbers up to 1,000. Children need to be able to compare and order numbers up to 200 initially with concrete resources and use greater than, less than and equal to symbols to compare. Your learners may be unsure as to which digit to look at when comparing, or may not have the conceptual understanding of the inequality and equal symbols, so you might click on the green misconception boxes, where you'll find a link to the same day intervention resource, where children can complete these intervention activities. By tracking the path all the way through the plan, you'll see how to develop children's learning from start to finish, or the horizon knowledge as it's expressed here. This is the point where your learners will have mastered the concepts and be ready for the following year. These small step planning documents for Key Stage 2 are completely adaptable to your teaching and to the needs of your child or class. They make planning maths mastery much easier and are available for every year group, including EYFS, and will soon be available for all strands of the maths curriculum. So take a look on the Twinkl website for the small step planning document that you need today and simply hit the green download button to get started. I hope this helped. Thank you for watching and I'll see you soon.